can't love. It's all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can't make it. Take my heart, but please don't break it. Love was made for me.
Allie, this is such a special day, honey. It brings back lots of memories for my mother,
yes,
and for me. But mostly I want you to know how proud we are of you, honey, and being your mother has been the most wonderful adventure of my life.
Thank you.
Allison, I'm so glad I can be here with you. I love your dress. I love you. I love everything about it. Your mom looks beautiful. Your dad looks beautiful. It is going to be a great night.
Yes, it is.
Ready?
Fingers. Yeah, but you have great legs. You have your mother's legs.
You better say that. Yeah.
This is, as your mother said, this is also one of the happiest days of my life because I'm not losing a daughter. I'm gaining a son-in-law, right?
Yes, exactly.
Right. I'm happy that you're going to be my sister-in-law, and I hope we have lots of fun times together. Allison, I love you like a sister, and I'm so, so happy for you. And I'm glad that I get to be a part of this with you, and I wish Brian and you the best. I love you.
Allison, one of my closest friends and one of my few very only friends. I spent a lot of time moving around, and I always knew there was someone out there who's always watching over me, who always called me. Always made me feel like there was someone who still cared about me back home. I love you.
I love you too.
I'm really honored to be standing in for you, and I'm going to be really happy to have you in my wedding too.
Thank you. Allison, I'm so excited for you. All the things we've gone through, this is the last thing I ever expected. And I'm so happy to be your maid of honor. I'm so honored that you let me do it. And I know you and Brian are just gonna have a wonderful life, and just anything you need, I'm always here for you. And I love you to death, and just don't forget to throw your bouquet to me.
Allison, me being the only family member here, I feel very honored that you've asked me to be in your wedding. You're my favorite cousin. We've gone through a lot in the past, and I know that there's going to be many great times in the future. Thank you for letting me be in your wedding. I love you.
Me too.
Allison, I think you look very beautiful, and thank you for having me in your wedding. I'm very glad to be in your wedding. Thank you.
Hi, Allie. I'm happy that you're getting married, and I love you.
Thank you, Lindsay. Thank you, everyone. It's a pleasure to have you all here, too. You mean a lot to me, and you wouldn't be standing up for me if you weren't as close to my heart as you all are as right now. And to my husband-to-be, I think you're a little bit more nervous than I am, so I hear. I've been cool as a cucumber until just about an hour ago, And I can't wait to be your wife, and I can't wait to kiss you at the altar, and I love you so
much.
That's
all you can wait for?
To be your wife forever and ever, forever and ever. I love you.
Hey, you got us.
That's it.
So hey, Brian. I'm Brian. I'm the groom.
And I'm the best man, Guillermo Cortez.
Yeah, he's the best man for many reasons, but primarily because he is the man. He is, without a doubt in my mind, my best friend, and for many reasons. This is one person I can fully trust and always will, and I feel very honored to have him on my side and standing up for me in my wedding. Do you have anything to say to that?
Yes, I do. I've known Brian for 11 years, and over those 11 years, I've gotten to know a great man. He's not only responsible, but he's very mature, and I haven't met a person who hasn't laughed when he's been around.
And I didn't have to pay him to say
our
that.
Families, our family's gonna definitely miss him that he's going to another family, but I wish him luck, and I think he's the, you know, he's definitely the best man here, and not me. So I'd like to wish him congratulations right now. And
thanks, Guillermo.
Goodbye.
Hey. Well, I do have one more thing to say before we go, because the time's getting short, but I'll get through this. I just wanted to say to Allison that I think you're making the best decision you'll ever make in your life. I'm very excited about our future together, and I can promise to you that I will do everything in my power to make you happy and to see that you grow and do the things that you want to do in your life, because I love you very much, and I'll see you in a few minutes, and it's going to be a wonderful life together. Thank you.
And I second that.
Thank you.
Maybe we can give your flowers to your best man right now. Okay? I'll help. So it's a pleasure to finally welcome the two of you, and in your name to offer a welcome to everybody else that's here, because we enjoy seeing not just a beautiful setting, but a beautiful event. People who offer to love each other the way God loves them, it's about the best thing you could do. So I offer their welcome to you, and I'd like to invite you not just watch me pray, but to, we'll take a moment of silence here. We can set up our little prayers heavenward. And God would like to hear from all of us. And then we'll start with the official prayer and all the rest of it, all right? So let's begin this as we do all good things in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Let's pray. Loving Father, hear our prayers today for Allison and for Brian, who today will be united in our presence and in yours, Lord. Give them your blessing. Strengthen their love for each other. We ask it through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Can all be seated, please, for our first reading.
If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
We will serve the Lord with gladness. above all, have love, which is the bond of perfection. Because you are God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with heartfelt mercy, with kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another. Forgive whatever grievances you have against one another. Forgive as the Lord has forgiven you. Over all these virtues, put on love, which binds the rest together and makes them perfect. Christ's peace must reign in your hearts, since as members of the one body, you have been called to that peace. Dedicate yourselves to thankfulness. Let the word of Christ, rich as it is, dwell in you. In wisdom made perfect, instruct and admonish one another. Sing gratefully to God from your hearts in psalms, hymns, and inspired songs. Whatever you do, whether in speech or in action, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus. Give thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Some Pharisees approached Jesus, and to test him, they asked, "Is it against the law for a man to divorce his wife on any pretext whatever?" He answered, "Have you not read that the Creator from the beginning made them male and female? That he said, 'This is why a man must leave father and mother and cling to his wife, and the two become one. They are no longer two, therefore, but one body.' So then, what God has united, man must not divide." The Gospel, the good news of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Be seated, please. Thanks for your patience. I'm going to ask that the couple and the rest of the people just take a little turn back so I can speak to them as well as to everybody. Would you mind just for this time? Thanks. Because I don't want to talk to your backs. I love you.
No. But I love more of you right here. I'm going to keep this short. I brought a little stool so that I would, you know, follow doctor's orders and not stay on my feet too long. What I'll do is remember to not talk so long. I think you'll like that. And everybody else here is in heels and stuff. In case you guys rented your shoes, I'm sure you feel the same. So it's wonderful to be celebrating something beautiful in a beautiful setting. Wish we could always remember, though, that the beauty of this thing is not what we see. Not typical for a priest to go, you know, throwing cold water on you. I mean, there's plenty of beauty here, but this isn't the real beauty of what we're celebrating, right? I mean, zillions of people are getting married on this weekend, I'm sure, through this vast land of ours. And some of them will be lucky enough to have nice places to do it in, such as, you know, our setting. Hey, what makes this really beautiful is that I know that inside of this lovely looking envelope is a letter. And the letter that's inside the envelope, as we heard what St. Paul said, you could have the most gorgeous envelope in the world. If it doesn't have a letter inside, it's squat. It's just a pretty envelope. If everything you do here, the beautiful ladies, good music, nice looking guys, the stuff, the flowers, what's going to follow, if all of that is simply a show, which it could be conceivably in some other dimension, not here because I know you guys love each other, but it could be just show, and if it were just show, that's all it would be. Pictures, good looking in the album, but then, hey, that album would be followed by another album, because how's it going to last if it doesn't have love? How's it going to be real if it doesn't have love? And what we get from these readings is that the love that you have for each other is the strongest kind, because it's not a human kind of, you know, one teaspoon per pint. No, we have industrial strength love. We have God present here. And if the love that, and I think we know it from people who are out here who are veterans of marriages, if the love that you bring to each other is God's love for you and for your partner, then how could that possibly ever dissipate? How could that possibly ever go wrong? How could that possibly ever run out? How could we go before a judge someday and say, cruel and unusual, or hey, she's not the same woman I married? Well, of course not. It's been 12 years, Jackson. You know, things happen. Or we've just grown apart. There's no growing apart if what's joining you is God's love for you. Because there's no growing apart from God unless you leave Him. Right? God does not have to be cajoled or anything. He's right there waiting for you. You give Him an ounce and He'll give you like 3 pounds. Because that's how God is. We know His love. That's why I like what you're doing. Because you're going to exchange not just your human love for each other, but God's love. And you know you have God's love. You've experienced that right up until now. In fact, this is a proof. If this isn't proof that God loves you, I don't know what is, right? Check it out. So it's wonderful. Someday there'll be women priests and they'll be, you know, flirting with the guy as it is. Anyway, so there it is. You have wonderful proofs all during your lives that God has brought you to this point. It's good to remember that, because there'll be a time when you won't be thinking so much of God and His loveliness, and you'll just be tired. And the emotions of, you know, being escorted by lovely people and beautiful music and a nice setting and a long-winded priest, all those emotions are going to be gone. And it'll just be the two of you, and somebody will say, hey, I thought I told you never to just drop that there again. Well, I forgot. That's when you're not going to feel too, you know, much like loving each other. And that's when you'll remember that what joins you is not the feeling of love, which is human stuff, but the conviction of love, which is God's stuff. What kept Jesus on the cross was not that He felt great about it. Okay? What kept Him there was this conviction that this is what the Father asked from Him. If you love Me, do what I ask you to do. And the kid said, do I have to, Dad? Do I have to? Like, is there a plan B? Remember the night before He's dying? He says, is there like a plan B? Do I have to die? Can't we like just get arrested or something? And the answer is the same. I'll do what has to be done. Wouldn't it be great if that's how you guys loved each other? Notice not keeping score, not keeping track of who got away with what, or who was forgiven the most, or just as God deals with you. And He asks you to do something in His name, which is to bring the love that He has for you to your partner. It's pretty easy. I mean, it's pretty simple. It's not easy. It's simple. But that's why we're here, because we're here to give you a little backup. We're here to be a church, even though we don't have walls and the rest of it. We're here to be the church, the body of Christ, the people who are, you know, born again into His Spirit. That's who we form here, not just an assemblage of friends. So, it's a sacred event. This is why Jesus says, what do you mean two? You know two. When they love each other as God loves them, they become one. Notice He didn't say that to have people be too embarrassed to use the D word. You know, D-I-V-O.
No, what he said was, if you thought about what beautiful stuff anchors you together, how could you possibly worry that anything's going to pull you apart? See? If you're aware that it is God's love that you exchange with each other. This is a call from God. I know it started with a little more like a call from the wild, because that's how we start, right? A little babe on the horizon, and you go, whoa, and then, you know, we get her phone number and stuff. But that's how it starts. That's, you know, good old human nature. But you're answering, obviously, by being here, by having a priest, you're answering a call from God. This is what he wants you to do. It won't be that much fun in the sense of, oh boy, it'll have fun moments, but it'll also have non-fun moments. Not to worry. They'll all be God moments. That's what he's asking you to do. Bring him to each other. No matter how it feels, bring him to each other. There's no way that anything will pull you apart if that's what you're doing. So I promised I'd try to be short of mouth. And turns out, yakety yak. So, but I mean, I felt I had to say a few things there. Are we ready to take our vows and everything? Good. Let me invite everyone to please rise to witness to these vows. Join hands, please. Nice. I will lead you to your vows by giving you the words to say. Okay, you say them as loud and slow or comfortable as you can do, okay? Alright. Since it is your intention to enter this Christian marriage, you've joined your hands, I ask you now to declare your consent before God and His church assembled here by repeating after me. Start with the gentleman. Hi, Brian.
Hi, Brian.
I'm talking right to you.
Hi,
take
Brian.
Take you, Allison.
Take you, Allison.
For my lawful wife.
For my lawful wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Good. Now it's Allison's turn. Hi, Allison.
Hi, Allison.
Take you, Brian.
Take you, Brian.
For my lawful husband.
For my lawful husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. And now bless the rings. May the Lord bless these rings which you will give to each other as signs of your love and fidelity. Please repeat after me. Take and wear this ring.
Take and wear this ring
as a sign of my love for you.
As a sign of my love for you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
I will be
Celebrate the Lord's Supper as a sign of unity. We celebrate some sign of union, love, a kiss. It depends how well you know the person next to you, I guess. A little hug, a nod, friendly smile, something. But let's do that now and offer each other the Lord's peace and love. Final blessings. Again, as I started by asking you to pray with me, not just watch me pray, as if I'm taking your place here or anything. I know I got the book and I got the podium, so to speak, and the traveling podium, 6-7. But anyway, I know that it's our prayers that make the church's prayer, not just the guy that's got the mic. So let's just put a nice amen to each of these three little lovely blessings that we wish upon our friend, all right? May God, the Eternal Father, keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and always be in your home.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. May your children bless you, your friends console you, and all men and women live in peace with you.
Amen.
May you always bear witness to the love of God in this world so that the afflicted and the needy will find in you generous friends and one day welcome you to the joys of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
And I ask the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon all of us and remain with us forever. Amen. Congratulations.
Thank you.
retirement home she gets.
Oh, okay.
But aren't you here to
nice. We're in the one home phone. Yeah. Right there. And I need a groom. Brent, please. Thank you. Come right here.
Brian Claude, wait, you need to sign your name.
And would you...
Where are you?
He's right here. Would you sign...
Sorry, Guillermo.
Would you sign the three names that are typed on here? Would you sign them right over here where it says groom and then on the copy down there?
We can get a picture.
Just three names.
Okay, yeah, we can do that.
Yeah, that's good. I'm glad.
I need a pillow when we go up to the head table.
I needed a table. That's fine.
Okay. Yeah. Yes.
Same thing.
I tried to put back all those tears, you guys. Nicole, do you have to leave? Are you waiting for me?
Good.
Ready in my life. Just kidding.
All right. Very happy to do that. Good. So now I need the best guy. Please. If you sign this, you normally sign just to the left of the bride. Right here, where it says witness, and right there, it says what? This would be the top of the witness. And then we'll get Guillermo. And then we'll get Guillermo.
You have your family there early, so.
I teased him. I said I was
going to
refuse to sign this.
Yeah, you better. You could. But you have to do something nasty to you.
Yeah, I know. I decided that wasn't
going to
be
nice
best.
Oh, thank you. Head out. You have one?
It's already 10 to 6.
Is this the rest, man?
I'm short on time. Okay, great, thanks.
Would you sign as you normally sign, right there where it says witness below her name and below her name?
Here?
As you normally sign, two places.
Okay, I need okay. You know what, Allison, where should you sit in the TV? In the middle, under the arch,
It's the big long table right up there. I can put that there for you. Let me just do that since I know where it is. Is this in case you get sleepy during the reception?
Yeah. Just waiting for Guillermo?
What I'm going to do is I'm going to give you back that copy.
Charity sign?
Okay.
No, thank you. The copy in that envelope. Well, maybe not because I need something to protect it until I get home.
Welcome to mine.
Yeah, really.
Yeah,
I grabbed my mother.
Yeah, I can relate.
Yeah.
That age where it's starting to happen. So, work out real hard.
Yeah.
No beverage.
Thank you.
Allison and Brian, I just got the finger, so I have to go now. I just want to tell you that thank you for having me at your wedding, and it was beautiful. It was an honor to sing for you, and everything is wonderful. And so I just wish you guys a lot of happiness and lots of love and joy, and I'll be praying for you. Pray for me. And here is Craig.
Uh-oh, I thought you were going to... I don't know who gave her the finger, but she got one. It was this finger. Allison and Brian, wish you guys a lot of luck. Thanks for having us do your wedding, do the music at your wedding. It was our pleasure. It was beautiful. May God grant you a long life of happiness together.
Amen.
Allison and Brian, I wish you all the best. I hope that you're as happy in your marriage as I am in mine. May God bless you always and guard you and guide you in His way, and never go to bed mad.
Yay! That's all.
Just changing exposures. There's my flash and it's ready.
I thought you were taking a picture.
Yeah, I was thinking about it. Right here.
People we would like to introduce. Let's put our hands together and welcome the bride's parents, Dr. Gloria and Mr. B. Larry B. Smith. They're followed by Brian's parents, Tony and Greg Orne. Let's have a round of applause for our bridesmaids and our groomsmen. First, we have Tori Orne and Andrew Smith. Following them, we have Renee Kavalek and Jason Smith. Let's have a round of applause for Amy Garrell and Rob Chipperfield. Next, we have Carla Hogarth and Dave Dustman. Let's also hear it for Wendy White and David Horn. A special round of applause for our best man and maid of honor, Ms. Mary Lynn Duquesne and Guillermo Cortez. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and welcome at their first social event together as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Brian White.
I like
sound, sweet gentle kiss, the way that your fingers run through my head, and how your scent lingers even when you're not there. And I like the way your eyes dance when you laugh, how you enjoy your 2-hour bath, and how you convince me to dance in the rain with everyone watching like we were insane. But I love the way you love me. Strong and wild, slow and easy, heart and soul, so completely I love the way you love me.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Brian White. Yes. As they make their way to the head table, I have to share something with you folks. I've been doing this for a very, very long time, and I don't think I've ever seen a bride and groom smile so much through their first dance. I think they deserve a round of applause for that. That means a lot from this end.
Where's the head table?
I'd like to invite you all to go ahead and have a seat. We are going to offer a toast here in just a very short moment as soon as they get over to the head table. So go ahead and relax.
What can I say? I'll start with Brian since I've known him for 11 years. Long time. But through all of our wrestling matches since we were 12 years old and so forth, in those 11 years I've gotten to know a great man and very responsible. When I lived with him, he was a very clean guy. But we liked him because he was kind of like a little slave to clean everything up. But he's very responsible, very hardworking, and very mature. It's a pleasure to see him grow. And it's been wonderful that now I'm the best man at this wedding. All right, Allison, let's see, in the time I've gotten to know her, I've gotten to know a very loving person, caring, and very mature woman. And to both the groom and the bride, any family should be very happy to have either of them in the family. We tried to keep Brian in our family as long as we could, but we had to let go. So, and Allison, I'd love to have her in our family also. And I wish you guys the best. You guys
are here.
Whoa,
thirsty.
Well, everybody, I guess Guillermo wasn't there because he took all the words out of my mouth. But I haven't known Brian half as long as I've known Allison, but I feel like I've known him forever. He's just the greatest guy. And Allison, you can't think of enough good words to describe her. She's just a wonderful person and a beautiful bride. And I know that they're going to be very happy together, and I'm very happy for them. And Allison's, I kind of consider her my sister. I think Mr. and Mrs. Smith are my parents, my co-parents. So I'm happy to say that I've gained a nice brother-in-law here. So the only thing I can say, and I have to tell everybody this because it's so important to me, and it's that you all have to hope that when she throws her bouquet, that it comes to me. I'm not going to be able to die for it, but I told her to aim for me. I need all the luck I can get. So.
Hey.
I just hope that you and Brian just have a wonderful marriage, and I'm always here for you. So, congratulations.
You're here. You're here.
Keep it short. Give an applause for Mary Lynn and for Guillermo there.
Sister has been quite a treat. Actually, I standing there looking at Brian and Allie, looking at each other, and the Smith van in the background brought back this fleet of memories. It's kind of like went by real fast, all the family vacations we took in the old Smith truckster. And I remember one time, kind of pretty precisely, Allie fell into a snowdrift. And it was about 6 feet deep, and she was probably about five, and I was seven, and I kind of felt like the big brother. I had to pull her out of it, and it's kind of been that way all my life. She has not needed much help going through life, as a matter of fact. I've had to kind of catch up to her, and I've been in her tailwind. She's got a lot going for her. Brian also does, and I wish them the best of luck, and they probably don't need it, but they're going to do just fine.
Pushed her into snowdrift.
Well, you can't prove a thing.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, dinner will now be served.
Okay, Allie, we've known each other for quite a long time, since high school. I remember all of the trips that we had to Flagstaff to go snowboarding or skiing or whatever we did. I've always thought the highest of you. I think you're a very respectable lady and you're going to do very well. I wish you the best of luck with Brian. I think you've got a fine groom and a fine husband. And I hope to see you in the future, and I hope to see you at my wedding. And I think the world of you, and good luck.
Allie, I'm so proud of you. I just wanted to say that I love you like a sister, and you're more than welcome to stay with me, you and Brian and the baby. Whenever you guys want, come down and visit me in Tucson. And I just wanted to say congratulations, and you deserve the best. You're the best person I've ever met, and you have the best personality, and I love you very much. There you go. Hey, Allie. I can't believe you're getting married before all of us. We never expected it, but we've always looked up to you, as Jason said. You've always been our inspiration. You're the one with the goals, the one who knew where she was going, the independent one. And Brian, you're getting the best girl in the world, and I know she loves you more than anything. So take care of that baby and come visit us all the time. You have free babysitting from all of us.
Definitely.
Hi, Allie, how are you? I'm up a little earlier than I thought, but that's okay. I want to wish both of you the best of luck. Brian, I hope you know that you have a great girl and that we're all very envious and that you should take care of everything. And Allie, make sure that you keep all of your dreams and aspirations alive, and Brian, you as well. And strive for them together and not apart. And I think that you guys have a very successful marriage, and I wish you both the best of luck. And since you're in Flagstaff, we'll see you at our annual ski trip on Memorial Weekend next semester.
Hi, Allison. It's Todd Wilson. How you doing?
In case you can't see him.
Well, I'm happy to be here and spending this occasion with you. I just happened to be in town, and it was an extreme shock to me that you were getting married. Brian, you have a great wife, and all the best to you.
Hi, Elliot. I just want to say congratulations to both of you and the best of luck to each of you. I thank you for having me here and whatever.
Hi, Allison. Just some of the things I could say. I've known you for a really, really long time, and I'm really happy that I could share this with you and with Brian. And I think that you have a really good life ahead of you, and I hope that each of you take care of each other, especially Brian, take care of Allison. We've known her for a long time, and just she deserves the best, and I'm sure you'll give that to her. And I just want to wish you both good luck. And this is not goodbye, because we'll definitely see you in the future.
We got a thought together.
Allie, our little roommate. Our roommate.
Aww.
Allie. Well, first of all, you took all of our furniture. We're only left with old green. We wish you the absolute best in your future. I know you deserve everything. You are a beautiful bride, and I wish the best for you and in your everything you do.
Allie, I'm just so happy to be here sharing your wedding with you, and gosh, I've known you since, junior high, and just watching you grow up, you're the most mature, beautiful young woman in the world, and you have so much going for you, and I wish you guys all the happiness, and I'm so happy for everything you have to look forward to in your future, and I hope you guys just have the best life together.
We still have summer school to look forward to, though, so you're not too far away from me.
Good luck, guys.
Good luck.
Congratulations, Allison and Brian. Allison, I haven't even met you yet. I'm Brian's Aunt Terry, Tony's sister, and I just want to welcome you to our family and tell you how really happy I am for you guys, and I hope you have a long and happy marriage.
Hi, this is Brian's grandma. We're happy for you guys, and we're so glad we could be here. This is wonderful. God bless you.
We love you. We're so privileged to be here and spend this day with you. We've enjoyed every minute of it.
Do you know that they like older kids? They love.
Hello, Allison and Brian. It's nice that you all have met and you have been united in marriage. I hope your future is bright for you, and I hope it's very happy in the times you guys are together in the future, and hope everything is happy and good for you. Okay.
Well, congratulations, Brian and Allison. We hope you'll be very, very happy, and we're looking forward to being a part of your family like you've been a part of our family for so many years.
Brian and Allie, I have many, many things to say to you. However, I would never put them on video. I'll save them for a time when we're alone, and for now, I'll just say congratulations.
Ditto that.
Hey, you two silly geese. This is Jess. I guess you can see me, so I don't have to say that, but I just wanted to say that I'm just really happy for you both, and thanks for letting me come out, and thank you for putting me at the parents' table, because this has been a whole lot of fun. Okay, thanks. Bye.
Congratulations to you both. I understand that you are paying for Jessica's round trip ticket back to New Hampshire. And since you're married, no more free rentals at Breckenridge.
Congratulations, Allie and Brian. We'd like to welcome Brian to the Smith family. We think you'll make a great Smith. And Allie, for my only niece, congratulations. Thanks.
Hey, Brian. Congratulations on you and Allison's marriage here. I want to take this time to invite you guys up to Idaho to our house and do some river rafting with us. So anytime you guys are free during the summertime, come up. It was a really nice wedding, and congratulations.
I hope you have many, many happy years of good, happy marriage. This is Russ. Is that enough?
Well, this is Grandma Warren, and we're so happy to have Allison join our family. And I know that Brian would have not chosen anybody that we wouldn't approve of. And we think an awful lot of Brian. We will of Allison also.
Well, I'm the FOB. the father of the bride, and I'm very happy to have Brian join our family. This has been quite an event. But one thing, Allison, that you need to always remember, and you got to teach Brian, is our favorite song, 369, the goose drank wine, the monkey chewed tobacco on the street for a line, the lion broke and the monkey got choked, and they all went to heaven in a little rowboat, clap, clap. You remember that, you got it made.
That does bring back memories, Larry, of all those good old trips. Well, Brian and Allison, I cannot wish more for you than all the happiness that we have shared as husband and wife, and I know you will too, because you have so many role models. As I sit around this table and I see your wonderful mother and father, my mother and my father, who's not here, and all the people who love you so much, you are loved, and because of that, you will always love your children.
The only thing I can say for Brian and Allison is I wish them the very best of everything from now on.
Well, Allison and Brian, everything's been said, and we go for every bit of it. And we love you. Okay.
Brian and Allison, I love you both very much, and I am so thrilled that you've come together and married. And I wish you both all the happiness in the world. And I'm so happy to have Allison as a daughter-in-law. She's a wonderful person. And I just wish you much happiness and joy through your married life.
Brian and Allison, I wish you the best. I guess if Larry's the FOB, I'm the FOG. And that's the way I feel most of the time. Thank you.
Brian and Allison, this is a grandmother's wish. All the happiness in the world, and if ever you need help, call Grandma.
To my fourth son, Brian, it has been hard to let go. Allison, I hand him over to you because I know that you will hold him close to your heart as we have. Please love one another and know that we will be walking with you throughout your marriage life. As Grandma Gloria says, call if you need help, or even if you need to sing with us, join us in Mass. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
I want to thank everyone for getting here and sharing in this special moment and day with us. And I just want to say that it's not just a coming together of two people, it's a coming together of two families. And I hope that we can make this step together and grow and learn about each other and meet each other. And I know when you first meet these people, there's this invisible barrier here. And sometimes you don't want to say, hi, my name's Brian Wayne. Very nice to meet you. Now I'm with Allison side of the family. So let's get past that and just step in. You know, sometimes you see that invisible wall right there.
Right.
I just got to step through. and shake some hands. But thank you very much for getting here today. Appreciate it.
For giving this wedding, which is almost like a dream for us. It brings me to tears to see all of your smiling faces here. And without our parents, Greg and Tony, and Larry and Gloria, we wouldn't be here and we would have never met. And Brian and I are definitely falling deeply in love. And we are just so thankful you could all be here to share that with us. And a special thanks to our wedding party who has so graciously given up their time and all of their whole life to be part of our life. And I just love you all so much.
And Guillermo and Mary Lynn.
Especially to our maid of honor and best man, Guillermo and Mary Lynn.
Hey,
we love you all.
Three.
Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. This, I'll tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other.
Let's see a big kiss for that, huh? There we go. And this state back here also have one you wanted to share? All right, stand up. Two, three, go.
Love, love me do. You know I love you. So please, love me do.
All right, give me a round of applause.
Oh, we're harmonic.
It was a far table back here. The table far back.
It'll be singing around.
One, two, three, go.
I love you. You love me. We're all happy family with a great big hug and a kiss from me to you. Don't you say you love me too?
Yeah! It's sort of scary when someone actually knows the choreography, don't you think? Oh my, we have any other takers, any other tables here?
Love you, a bushel and a heck, a bushel and a neck, and a hug around the neck, a hug around the neck, and a barrel and a peck.
Okay, one at a time. He goes first.
With my fingers?
Yeah, with your fingers. He had to ask.
Right here with the knife, Brian. Wait, I can't see your face. Gotta see your face.
I need to know what's going on here.
A lot of tongue. We want to see a lot of tongue there. There you go. Okay, you guys clean up now. At least you didn't get mad. That's good.
My one and only chance. After thinking about this for about the last 4 or 5 months, I've decided that I would kind of make a list. If anybody knows my wife, Gloria, who is largely responsible for this wedding this evening, you know that she loves to make lists. Unfortunately, she puts too many things on lists, and they're usually for me to do. When I did this list, I thought I'll call it down to about 10, and I want to do the top 10, Allison Father's top 10 pearls of wisdom for a long and happy marriage. Now, Gloria's probably thinking, I don't know 10, maybe 3, maybe 4. And she's right, I don't. So as a result, I went and did a little research on some of the local Southwestern cowboys to see what they thought, and I kind of combined them. So here it is, my top 10 list. Number 10, top 10 pearl of wisdom for a long and happy marriage. Do what I say and not what I do, most of the time. Number 9, my mama always said, a good marriage is like a bowl of chili, hot and spicy with a little gas. Number 8, 2 words, happy in-laws. No, 3 words, very happy in-laws. Number 7, marriages made in heaven only work when they get down to earth. Number 6, a man can build a house, but it takes a woman to make a home.
Yeah.
Number 5, my daddy always said, to be good at marriage is like being good at golf. Practice a lot, hit them straight, stay out of the hazards, and don't fudge your score. Number 4, if you've got love in your heart, you've got spurs in your sides. We all know that. Number 3, treat the one you love like the way you want treat your horse. No one likes to be rode hard and put away wet. Guess where that came from? Number 2, if a woman can't make you miserable, she can't make you happy. And number 1, the number 1 pearl of wisdom for a long and happy marriage, the best way to get married is with ignorance and confidence. And now for a toast. So Allison and Brian, on your first day of your long life together as husband and wife, you two must remember this. No matter how complicated life appears to be, the simpler you can keep it, the happier you'll be, i.e., all together now. A kiss is just a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. Here's looking at you, kids.
That was very kind. Thank you very much, Mr. So let's have another round of applause for him as well. That was well prepared. Fine list. And in fact, we're going to reward you by now inviting you to dance with your daughter.
That's what we are. Unforgettable, though near or far. Like a song of love that clings to me. How the father knew does things to me.
Someone been there. Unforgettable.
There. All right, ladies and gentlemen of the bridal party, we'd like you all to join us on the dance floor, please. round of applause. Marathon dancers there. For hanging out with us and dancing, we got another hour or two of the party. But right
now, just be sad.
I love family.
Look at that. Wow. Might never be mean. Might never be cross or try to be boss. But they wouldn't do for nobody else. Give me a thrill with all your fun. Still, it had to be you. Wonderful you. It had to be you. Noting ladies, if you want to dance.
Hi, Brian and Allison. This is Uncle David, and I just want to wish you guys all of the best. And, you know, I sent you a very special wedding present, and I hope that you'll read it and enjoy it and heed it. Have a real good life. Best of luck to both of you. Thank you.
For your contributions, we hope that we appreciate you that. But not yet. this guy right here, what's your name? Was it John? That was John? John. It's John. John apparently has some gender issues he's working out, but oh my, did you see anybody else? How about people over the age of 25 or 30? There are two more ladies back there. Come on, ladies, we're waiting for you. Come on up. Thanks. And, okay, that's all right. We've got a couple minutes for ladies. Yes, you have to wait just a moment. we also, we're also aware of the fact that you all know that Allison went to school in NU, right? Clearly, we're going to help her count to three then. All right, Beck, that's all right. I can't make it to two. I graduated from ASU, what am I saying? And in fact, I can't make it to two, so what I'm going to need is your help on this, ladies and gentlemen. What we're going to do to be, first of all, we got all single ladies up, right, Mike? Okay, what we're going to do, I'm going to say three. I need you all as loud as you can, even those of you sitting down, to say two and one, as loud as you can. If you do it loud enough, Allison's going to throw that bouquet. If not, you're going to have to start all over again. So I'm going to say three. I need a two and a one from you. Here we go. Three, two, one. Oh, my, brutal. Was that Marcia there? Was that Marcia that almost tore her cruciate ligament trying to catch the bouquet? I don't even want to throw it again because I'm afraid somebody might get hurt by her. So let's go ahead and hand her that hand, Marcia. We appreciate the valiant effort there. Marcia did a great job at catching the bouquet there. We'll give it to her. Oh my, I'm glad we waited. Is everybody else okay? Anybody lose a nail on that? Oh my, okay ladies, you want to go ahead and have a seat for just a moment, please. We're going to do the guys now. And we need Guillermo. Take your time, Brad. There. Very well done for such an intimate moment in front of so many friends, right? All right, Allison, we'll invite you to go ahead and step to the side for just a moment. And Guillermo, you're single, right? You have no ring on? All right, we'll have you stand back with the rest of the guys here. I need you guys all to kind of step back just a little bit and okay, we're not ready quite yet. We're almost there. Almost there. I gotta make sure everybody's sort of configured properly. Yeah? All right. All right. Not quite yet. I know you guys are a pretty good group here. Don't drop those drinks as you come down. All right. Okay. Allison says, hey, wait. Come on, you guys. Nice one. That's right. Are we ready, Michael?
I'm ready when you are.
Ready, okay. Same deal. I'm going to count to three. I need a big two. In fact, I'll tell you what. To be fair, I know it's really true. You guys have a hard time with three, two, and one. So how about we go N-A-U? How's that? Not you. You guys show out all right. How about ASU? U of A? How about three, two, one? We'll go back to three, two, and one. I don't want any bloodshed here. Here we go. I'm going to say three. I need a two and a one from you. Here we go. Three, two, one. Congratulations, who's the young man that caught that? I couldn't see. Who's the gentleman that caught that? Oh, that was Andrew, right? Andrew, congratulations. We need Marcia for one quick picture. Andrew, if you'll come up and stand next to Marcia for just a moment.
Okay, right there. That's it,
good. All right. That's right. You can take us out to the tables if you want to, Marcia. Let's swing it out there. Grab some of those people. You need to be creative too. Whatever the person in front of you does, you need to do too. So, see if we can get some conga kicks going. A little kick to the left and a little kick to the right. Real tight. Go back that way to your left. Go back to your left. Well, other left. And give some high fives to these people as you go by. Let's do some high fives as you go by. Yeah? threw the wig into your eye. That's right. Let's spiral this thing back around. You guys having a good time? Make some noise!
Time.
All right, here we go. Guys, you can do better.
Boom, boom, boom,
boom. Not bad. Here we go, change words. Danny Terrio, this is Dance Fever. Let's hear it for dancers number one and two. We need
I wonder how spent the lonely night, dreaming of a song, the melody haunts my reverie. But that was long ago. Now my consolation is in the stardust of a song. Beside the garden wall, when stars are bright, you are in the light. The nightingale tells his fairy tale, a paradise where roses bloom. Though I dream in vain.
Thank you.
sister, you know.
Once again, we'd like to have Josh, John, and Chris up to the dance floor with the ride with Bryce here. Josh?
It is where we are.
Kings and vagabonds believe the